Greetings, engineers, and welcome to How To Factorio. In this playthrough tutorial, I will attempt to explain every single decision, or at least most of them, that I make, specifically to answer questions with regards to where to place things, what size to build, certain things that have come up in the last few weeks. So these decisions will be based upon the circumstances for the map and not necessarily relevant to every single map. Greetings, engineers, welcome back. So we did sneak back, and we didn't have a problem. However, something I want to show you straight away on the map. Not that bit. This bit. Yep, we've got this area uncovered, which is like, yes. But also, it looks here like this is just like a bit that might just end. But once we clear these biters out, we might have a huge area being biter free. Which means it's going to be very defensive, bendable. Which is again like yes. I'm happy now. So, between episodes, I have expanded power. So we've got plenty of it. We've got 80 steam engines now. And I've also ran lubricant and sulfuric acid onto the bus. Which, well, it's just running pipe and weaving, so I'm pretty sure everybody can do that. But we now want blue belts, red circuits, blue circuits. So let's crack on. On the left hand side here, these belts get in the way. But on the right hand side they don't. So since we're not going to be using a ton of blue circuits right now, then, well, we're just going to build on the right. So, the fun thing is we've got a chest full of red. Blue circuits require gears. You go to blue belt. Is there. And this arrow appears. That's where we need lubricant. Wait, hang on. Out at the top, in on the bottom. Red belt. Going up to there. Coming in from this bus. Go that way. Don't need that. Power pole. And power pole there. Chest. So now we need lubricant. I'm going to fetch lubricant up down here. Wait, I'm going to need to mark this. Oops. Just New Add Factorio. Right, so lubricant. I'm gonna go here. Make you continue from there. Get you out. And that's our lubricant link. Oh, we need to take it up. Up, 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 and away. No, well, sort of. Do that. Square there, square there. And red belt. Oh yeah, red belt. Ah. Well, we need to get rid of the red belt, so just shove it into a chest and do that. Get it all converted. There we go. So when this chest is empty of red belt, it'll start taking from that belt. I wonder if it would go faster. Two. Slightly. Two. Double you guys up? Nope. I think we're at the fastest we can go for the time being. But that's blue belt on the go. So, we now want red circuits. Now. Red circuits is going to be a problem. Because this lot's in the way. I was hoping to avoid it. First question is, how big do we need this to be? So let's have a look. Red circuits will require 2 green, 2 plastic, 4 copper cable. So, plastic we can fetch up. 2 green circuits. Yeah. 4 copper cable. Well, we can make the copper cable. But green circuits require iron plate, copper cable. I know what I'm thinking. I'm thinking of making the green circuits for the red circuits. Actually on this thing. In fact, I'll go even further than that. I'm thinking of making one production line that'll kick out both red and blue. Because blue, if we have a look, cannot be handcrafted because it requires sulfuric acid. It also requires green and red. So I'm just trying to think how best to do this. Because otherwise what we're doing is we're taking these green circuits, dropping them onto belt, pulling them off to make red, dropping red onto the belt, and then pulling red up and green up, make blue. So instead, make the green that goes into red. Make sure any excess red goes onto the belt, but blue gets its pick. Now we've got blue belts being made, so I'm thinking this has to be made with blue belt. But if I put copper cable straddling a blue belt, then have the electronic circuits and plastic bar we can just fetch up on half a belt, blue belt. That's going to be interesting because we'll need blue undergrounds and blue splitters. Well, we'll need blue splitters for plastic bar. Having said that, can we make blue? No. Needs a machine. So, I think this production line is going to have to get changed. Which means all of this is in the way. That's awkward. It is in the way. Right, I have an idea. I do have an idea. This is where bots would be so much more helpful. move these lines without actually disconnecting. Hopefully. Although I must admit, waiting for these to actually be pulled up is rather annoying. Where is the top one? There's... Right, so that's the copper supply routed to the top from the bottom. And voila! Because we're not actually chewing through that much copper at the moment. So we'll leave a second line in there just in case. Sometimes it just so happens that in the interim we need a bit more. That's why. Right, that creates some space. Miners. Meh. Right. Got a load of yellow belt now. Oh well. What was I doing? I can't wait and remember. Right, yes. So, let's make green circuits first. So we need to fetch up copper and iron. Okay. So, I am going to interrupt you. you there. Drop you there. Gonna bring up copper and iron. I'm gonna fetch them up on red. Even though, strictly speaking, I should be going to blue. Yeah, I'll stick with red. Gonna be too much of an issue to upgrade to blue right now. Wait, what am I doing? Numbskull! Right, so what we are doing is copper cable to green. Oh, we didn't do the copper splice. Hang on. Mm-hmm. Right, and we're kicking you out here onto, well, we could use yellow belt, but onto a red belt. And I'm going to chuck a power pole right there. Right, so, green circuits. Now, wet circuits require green circuit. We also need plastic bar. We also need copper cable, but we don't need iron anymore. Guess what? Get rid of you. Okay. I have an idea. Do that. That's the right way. See, we allocated four belts for green. And yeah, we haven't got that far yet. Right, there's our plastic. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. There we go. Right. So, red. I'm going to have to make the copper cable. There we go. Boom, boom. You, copper cable. You, red. Okay, and fast inserter, fast inserter. Three long arms, make sure we're at max speed. Right, now, we need green circuits, but we're going to do something funky with green circuits. Oops. We're going to flip the side of the belt. Green circuits. So here we're in, here we're out. Shaking it all about. Help all abuse. I'm going to turn it all around. Wait. Oh, yep, there we go. Red circuit. Now, red circuits not being created very quick, are they? How much space have I got? Oh, I've got a fair bit. Let's have a look here. 8 seconds. You're 15 seconds. I need some more wet circuits. I'm going to go with 3, I guess. Not. That's just annoying. Save a little bit of space. In, out. Great. And pop all of you. Lots of abuse. Abuse is good. Abuse is fun. More abuse. Ha. Huh. Well, I thing is, 2 copper cable every 5 seconds. So that's 1 second to create 4. We have a look in here, 4 copper cable every 8 seconds. So it would actually only take 1 second for them to create it. So. I have a better idea. Oh, come on. Right, so instead of this one passing straight up, like this, what we're gonna do is we'll use a long arm. Might change the plan here. Do that. Strictly speaking, there's more that we can do. 2 going out. Second belt going up. No! We're out of bread! Well, there's still plenty in here. Oi. I saw that. Got enough machines. Got enough of the other stuff. Right. So, if we chuck that sucks. Here we go. Do we have? Yes. We have assembly machine 3s. But anyway, what we can do. Oh wow! Well, I am terrible at timekeeping. Yep, we're gonna continue this on the next episode. May take a while to build, but we will get there. So, if you like this video, leave a thumbs up. If you like the series, hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to hit the alarm bell as well. But hope you have a good evening, afternoon, morning, whatever time it is for you. Take care, have fun, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.